Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Coach Manny. I'm a coach here at Ohana Academy.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. How long have you been doing jiu-jitsu for, sir?
11 and a half years now.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's been a lot of fun. A lot of memories.
Sure. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Do you enjoy doing Brazilian jiu-jitsu?
Yeah, it's pretty much my whole day revolves around it. I started at like 6 and it ends at like 8 o'clock at night with jiu-jitsu. So the whole day just jiu-jitsu, nothing else.
Okay, sure, yes, sir. Did you, is that your first style of fighting? Did you have like a wrestling background coming into it, or is this just
how jiu-jitsu? No, I always did other sports, very common, like, you know, American sports. Yes, but then, once I started to realize a lot of these sports were based on height and weight and physical attributes, I wanted to find something that wasn't about that. And then jiu-jitsu was like about technique, and it didn't matter how big or small you were. And I really enjoyed that. Like, it was like, okay, everybody has a fair shot. It's just about putting in the work.
Yeah. Okay, yes sir, yes sir. How important do you think Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is compared to like boxing, Muay Thai, or do you think like do you rank those other styles of fighting ahead of those, ahead of Jiu-Jitsu, or do you rank Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu over all of them? Or what do you rank like number one, two, or three?
So for me, the best would always be Jiu-Jitsu, because like whenever you start a fight, like it's really easy to start throwing punches, and then the moment somebody gets hit, they want to like close the distance and start like, you know, like getting body locks or like, you know, holding you. And if you're the kind of person that knows how to grapple, you know, you can really defend yourself from attacks, submissions. If you're a young woman, you know, when people are trying to like hold you or throw you around, you know, it's really important that you understand just body awareness and mechanics. So like absolutely for like self-defense and like, you know, give yourself a fair ability, like I think this is like hands down the best form of martial arts for self-defense.
Okay, yes sir, yes sir. So if you had to give advice to somebody who's first starting Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, what's your first advice to give them? Like, what would you tell them if they're first trying to start training for Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu?
Man, just don't be hard on yourself. Don't limit yourself. Like, you're starting something new, so you're not going to be the best at it, right? Like, enjoy that. It's really refreshing to not be good at something and you have to challenge yourself.
Yes, sir.
Always, like, you know, be patient, because Jiu-Jitsu is a sport where impatient people will not get immediate gratification. And we'll be like, well, it's not for me. It's like,
yes, sir.
You know, be
and that person learned that the hard way.
Yeah,
definitely.
Like, it's a patient sport, and it will humble you and make you, you know, respect technique versus brute strength. And then just always make sure at the end of the day, whatever gym or you go to, is there's good vibes. You know what I mean? You don't want to go to a place that's like making you feel like you got to abuse yourself. You know, you should be having fun. And at the same time, learn how to protect yourself. You know, there's a fine line between, you know, being an MMA fighter and just being a hobbyist. And just always make sure you're happy wherever the gym you join. And always think about your well-being. You're doing it by joining Jiu-Jitsu.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. And do you still compete, coach?
Yeah, I got a fight this Saturday.
Okay, for
I
sure. Good luck to you. Good luck to you. You got it, coach.
I compete a lot.
Yes, sir.
It's just in Jiu-Jitsu, there's competitions. And the beauty of these competitions is some sports, once you hit a certain age, you can't really compete. And there's
true,
MMA,
yes,
but like stepping in a cage is really a big step up there. And you know, for young adults who still have that adrenaline rush that like wanna like challenge themselves, man,
yes,
Jiu-Jitsu competitions, they're safe, they're for everybody. Anybody could do them. You just have to like, you know, train adequately and, you know, but you know, yeah, definitely.
Yes, sir. Well, it was a pleasure having you. Hello, coach. How you doing?
Good.
How you doing today? How you doing? Go ahead and introduce yourself.
I'm Gabe Renaga.
Gabe
Renaga.
I'm
here, one of the managers here at Ohana Academy.
Okay, yes, sir. Yes, sir. How long have you been doing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for?
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, I got started in 2009.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I didn't focus on it too much initially. Mm. I did it, but it was, I grew up doing karate.
Okay, yes, sir.
So I felt most comfortable. Professor Jason used to teach the Muay Thai, also
yes,
the
sir.
MMA. So
okay,
I gravitated more to the striking.
Okay, yes, sir.
But after my last fight, I fought 3 times in the cage.
Mm-hmm.
2014 was my last fight.
How'd that go for you?
I won. I got
you
the,
won?
I
okay,
got
congrats, the, congrats.
I was 42 years old at
yes,
that
sir.
Time.
Yes, sir. Okay.
And I just went ahead and said, no more getting punched in the head.
Wow, okay, yes, sir.
And I
for
focused
sure.
on jiu-jitsu.
Okay, yes, sir.
100%.
Are you, I heard you were a 2018 champion, world champion?
World champion.
2018?
Brown belt.
Brown belt, okay,
in
okay.
In my age category.
Oh, nice, nice. Congrats to you, congrats.
Thank you,
congrats.
So much.
So how important do you think Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is compared to like Muay Thai, boxing, or any other forms of fighting? How do you compare it to all
Well, for me, like I mentioned to you, I grew up doing karate. For myself, doing other martial arts, I enjoy them. And okay. I think that it's all personal preference.
Okay, okay, yes, sir.
Some people prefer the striking over the grappling.
The grappling, yes, sir.
For me, I'm just hooked on the challenge of it.
Okay,
be able
okay.
to manipulate the human body in such a close contact, because it's different than striking. Striking, you're dealing with ranges.
Exactly, yes, sir.
And for me, the ability to be able to impose your will on somebody who's trying to, you know,
strike you and stuff. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's just different. So I mean, but as far as like from what I tell parents is, mm-hmm. I like it because it resembles life Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Okay.
So does the other martial arts. But it's difficult to go 100% every day mm-hmm. striking in, say, Muay Thai or some of the other striking arts.
Yes, sir.
Because I can't punch you 100%. You can't
exactly.
kick me 100%.
Exactly.
One of us can get busted up.
Exactly, exactly. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But in jiu-jitsu, you can. Uh-huh. You can go 100%. You can choke the heck out of your
exactly.
partner.
Exactly. Armbar or triangles, whatever.
And
yes, sir.
If it hurts, you tap and you restart.
Exactly,
you
exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
so the realness of it, mm-hmm. especially for kids, mm-hmm. if they ever get in a conflict, mm-hmm. they've been in that rough situation where they had to stay calm, problem solve.
Exactly, exactly.
You
yeah.
know, and so it's nice. It's
Most
good.
Definitely, yes sir, yes sir. So you prefer Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu over karate or any other
right
ones?
Now,
or,
right now, I mean, my okay. roots are always karate, uh-huh. But I'm a perfectionist.
Okay,
so,
okay,
so
yeah.
until I'm the best at this,
okay.
I'm like, man, I'm hooked on this.
That's a great mindset to have, coach. That's yeah. a really, really great mindset to have. Not a lot of people have that mindset, to be honest. Like, do you think just the way like,
it's
you're thinking
hard
right
to,
now?
Like, I have friends that tell me, oh man, what are you doing? You know, you grew up in karate. You should be teaching karate. You should be training in karate. Yeah. And it's just hard to balance everything.
Exactly, you know? Yeah, exactly. Because like, I feel like me personally, like I just started doing this. And I just realized that it takes a lot of training, sir. Like, it takes a lot of training compared to, like, boxing. Like Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a whole nother level, like, of just, you know, just, like, a different level of, like, fighting. You know what I mean? Because, like, I feel like it's most definitely on, like, on the wrestling side a little
yeah.
bit. Or, like, what would you compare it to, like?
It's a scramble. Like, uh-huh. What you end up finding out is you watch two white belts roll together.
Uh-huh.
And there's a lot of, like, scrambling that you would see in wrestling.
Okay, okay, exactly.
And the
exactly.
higher you go, uh-huh. the less scramble you'll see.
Okay.
And then it's just now more just like one grip.
Okay.
You know, you find more scramble in the no gi.
Oh, uh-huh, okay.
But I mean, the part about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is it's just so many small details.
Exactly.
The difference
exactly,
of whether
exactly.
an elbow in or an elbow out
mm-hmm.
can be the difference whether you get stuck into
exactly.
a submission.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You have any upcoming events coming up for
I
you?
Do, yeah. Uh-huh. So I'm going to be more than likely competing at the Houston Open. I'm signed up for that.
Uh-huh.
I'll be competing at the Nogi Pan American Championships
okay,
up in
yes,
Dallas.
Sir, yes, sir.
That's on my birthday, May
15th. Yes, sir. Good luck. Good luck to you. You got it, coach. You got
and
it.
And then I showed you the cover of the Submission Hunter Pro.
Oh, yes, sir, yes. I'm going to be reposting it on my Instagram, guys. So y'all go check it out, guys. It's going to be on my page. It's going to be on my story. Sure, yes, sir. So, coach, how you doing? How you doing today?
How you doing?
Go ahead and introduce yourself, coach.
My name is Jason Diaz.
This is Jason Diaz? Okay, okay. How long have you been doing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for?
I started back probably in the mid-90s.
Mid-90s, okay.
When it was barely fresh on the scene.
Okay.
UFC had just started, the UFC 1,
uh-huh.
and I was grappling more than anything. And so I did that for a few years.
Yes, sir.
Stopped, started back up when I moved here to San Antonio, from mm-hmm. originally from Houston. So I picked it up again, but was never really able to stay committed for a very long time until 2015 when I found Ohana Academy.
Okay,
and since
yes,
2015, I've been doing it ever since.
Okay, okay, for sure. I know. What are you, black belt? Or
brown belt?
Brown belt, for
brown
sure,
belt.
For sure. What's the biggest advice you can give to people on like Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu? Like, let's say they want to start it off. Like what's the first thing you would tell them? Like?
Well, I mean, I've heard this quote, and I'm a believer in it. There's a couple things. First one is that I love the mats because the mats are going to expose every lie and confirm every truth.
Yes, sir.
So, and on top of that, you know, when you start out this journey, it's not an easy one. But if you have it in your mindset that always a student, no no matter where I'm at in that journey, white, blue, purple, brown, black, makes no difference. I am always a student. Yes, I'm never bigger than the person next to me. And so, and I know that from a blue belt, from a purple belt, brown belt, I still can learn from the belt beneath me because I'm always a student. You know? And so that translates on the mats as well as off the mats in life. And if you can always have that, then you're always growing.
So, how do you compare Brazilian Jiu Jitsu to like Muay Thai, boxing, karate? Like, what is there, like, do you think there's like do they go like in order, or like which one do you think is the most important?
Well, I mean, I would have to say, and I want to do my best to not be biased in how I respond to this because I love Jiu Jitsu.
Yes, sir.
But I'm a strong advocate. I'm selling what I have a passion for constantly. And so if I'm talking to a female, and this is what I'm going to tell a female, out of all the martial arts that are out there, jiu-jitsu is probably going to be the best one for you. And the reason why I say that is because 9 out of 10 times, if you find yourself in a confrontation, you're going to be overpowered. And if you're overpowered, you're going to find yourself on the back.
Exactly.
Jiu-jitsu is going to teach you how to defend yourself. First, it's going to teach you how to be comfortable in uncomfortable situations. That means you're not going to panic. Because if you panic, it's done. And so the other arts have their places and their strengths, you know. And but for me, in my opinion, jiu-jitsu is probably, because 95% of all confrontations when they take place end up on the ground anyway.
Exactly. Yeah. The fight always ends up on the ground. Yeah, that's one thing I realized with this.
And if I have somebody that's telling me they want to be a mixed martial artist, I'll tell them, it's like, okay, we need to lay a foundation because you're going to build a house.
Yes, sir.
But before you build a house, can't start with the roof.
Exactly.
You've got to start with the foundation.
Down below, yes, sir.
A really, really good foundation. And jiu-jitsu is that foundation. Okay. Then you can add Muay Thai. Then you can add boxing. Then you can add all these other different things that'll provide you just a good sense of being a well-rounded fighter.
Yes, sir, for sure. And are you still competing, coach?
Actually, I competed as a white belt. I competed as a blue belt. I've got about 18 gold medals and one silver.
Oh, wow. Okay. So, congrats. That's a good resume. That's a really good resume.
So,
wow.
I slowed down a little bit as a purple because at that point, I really wanted to embrace the art and learn the art.
And then
more about technique, because all those tournaments that I had, there was some technique involved.
Exactly.
But for the most part, it was my sure will to want
to win. Yes, sir.
I'm going to win this.
Hell yeah.
And so I was like, you know what? I'm a purple belt now. It's just got real. And so let me slow things down a little bit. Let me learn the art more.
So
I didn't compete once as a purple belt. As a brown belt now, I've got this desire to want to go out there, not to prove myself, but to just test and to compete again. So from a healthy disposition.
Yes, sir. It's a pleasure to have you on the interview, coach.
Yes, thank you for having me.
Thank you for being my interview, coach. For sure. Thank you.